35x off of Gavin. There we go. So that's all the Stevenson brothers going around the ring at the moment. David Brown 900. I've got a card in that somewhere. Russell McNabb's. It's a 1957 40 horse for David Brown 900. Purchased from Raven in Suffolk 2 years ago, where it was used to pull a gang mower. It's just been recently restored. Russell, who is our newsletter editor and collector of David Brown tractors. Again, from Russell McNabb. They're not all David Brown colours. Here's a blue one. Russell McNabb Springs Farm in 1964, Forbes and Super Dexter, 38 horsepower. Spent his working life in a farm near Offenleck. Bought and restored 2 years ago. All panels on it are original. And that's very difficult to find these days. Thank you, Tom. From John McCation at Saltport, 1975 Muirhill. It's a 121 Mark II, it's 120 horsepower. Bought locally in 2003 to haul heavy trailers. It's now used for road runs. And a good view of the country can be had. In other words, from that height you can see all over the hedges and see what's going on. Right, Tom. Now this is coming back into the Fortune Ends. This is from David Naismith at Lismahagel. 1937 Fortune. What they term the old water washer. That's it, the air washer, the air cleaner went through a water bath, and if it blew back then you get wet knees. But you got wet knees here today anyway, so it didn't make any difference. It was built in August 1937, fast registered in Fife. After this, no history is known until 1973. But it's a nice model of that age, 1937 Fordson Model N. And this is Jimmy Hamilton with a David Brown Selectomatic 880 from 1968. At least he knows the date. He probably doesn't know his birthday, but never mind. Thanks, Jimmy. From Norton at Knocking Fibber Farm, a 1962 Fortune Major, model DDM. Started life at Rossi Home Farm at Inchcure. So again, it's a Perthshire tractor come to Ayrshire. And again from Donald Morton at Knocking Fibber, 1986 case, it's a model 1394, started life in Norfolk. So, you know, they come from all over the globe. Now this is an unusual one for you, from Tom Blackwood, the man with the Packard, he's there around the ring. It's Tom Blackwood from Stourton, 1929 Rushton, 1428, 28 horsepower, it was made to compete with Thompson, a better tractor, but dearer, so non-standard.
There you go.
Now, Thomas got a collection of tractors, unusual tractors. That's the Rushton, this is the Turner, vertical diesel engine. From the Tom Blackwood at Stourton again, 1950, Turner diesel, 4-litre V engine, 40 horsepower. Tractor built in Wolverhampton, too expensive compared to Nuffield and Fordson, and there's very few of these still around, so it's a very scarce model. Right, it's a 1961 Alistana VD40. Again, it's a very scarce model, there aren't too many of them around in the circuit, but it's been nicely prepared and restored. Thank you, from Jeff Graham at Stourton, 28 horsepower. A lot of tractors from that age group are around the sort of 28, 30, 40 horsepower. It's only now that we're into the hundreds of horsepower. And this is Tom McBurney and the tractor. It is, isn't it? Oh, I see. It's a... can't remember the year of it. It's a PE20 which was restored by the club and was won as a raffle tractor on our 25 year celebration. So it's Tom McBurney from Bigger, it's PE20 petrol paraffin. It's got a 1965, 1970, Burton pair, and there's a whole lot more to come. One of many Ferguson's owned by the Stevenson brothers. And Gavin comes with a 175. He's the big brother. He comes with a 175. So that's the older one. So what year is it, Gavin? 1965, 165. Right.